Yeah, well, they're very much in the process of turning into a Division One program, so we know that with the new coach they have, they're going to be a good team and a very good team in the future. So I think it's important that we can come out and start and establishing ourselves at home to be a pretty force to be reckoned with. And I'm really looking forward to having our players play in front of our fans who came out in numbers for our first game against Slick. So it's important that they come back out and we can show them a good performance and against a very good Dixie State team who'll be organised, who'll be ready to play. It'll be the first official game, so they'll be up for it, and I'm very confident that our players will be up for it as well, and it should be a really good game to watch.
I think we're really excited to just get out here and show the school what we've been working on for the past couple of weeks. I think our confidence level is pretty high. We're pretty stoked for the rest of the season. I mean, you said we have new coaches, new staff, we have a new logo, new Roar mentality, so we're really excited. We like to focus on us and what we're doing and just keep improving, so the opponent really doesn't matter.
Thankfully we went to Boise in the spring, so we're pretty familiar with the setup there, so that'll be a little bit of a perk for us. We're very much looking forward to the game. I think that New Mexico State are going to provide a few different types of opportunities for us to exploit different areas of the pitch compared to the Friday game. So again, it's just another opportunity for our players to develop and keep learning about themselves, and every game we're learning different things about each other. We're improving day by day, and I think come Sunday we'll be better than what we are today, and hopefully we can start finding the back of the net and stop conceding so many sloppy goals on set pieces.
I think we just need to stay strong and know that we're supported no matter what.
Players like Mary were holding the central area very, very well. Carl had a great game back there at the back. McKenna Bambi is starting to come through as a really good number nine for us, centre forward. So, you know, the way we played that game on the first half, we looked like a different game, a different team the second half. So I think it's important that can we start replicating good performances and carrying those out for 90 minutes instead of just 45. So I think, yes, definitely, we had to, SDSU had to change their game plan, which is nice when the opposition have to accommodate for things that you're giving to them. But I thought we dropped off a little bit too soon in the second half, and I would love to see our players be able to continue to thrive deep in the game and create chances and not pull the trigger too soon, which unfortunately we did a few times and it just didn't pan out the way we wanted it to. But again, we live and we learn, and we're getting better, and we've worked on it today and they look much better in front of goal.
We're working on really just staying mentally and physically ready the entire game. Just putting together an entire two halves is our main focus in these couple of practices.